If you're like me, then you have probably misplaced your TV remote at least once in your life and then went on looking for it all over the place. In today's video, we are going to solve this issue once and for all. We are going to build a Wi-Fi remote that we will never misplace because we never have to touch it or move it. And if you wonder why, it's because we will use it through a web browser on our PC or a phone. The way TV remotes work is by sending patterns or codes over infrared to our TV to let it know which button we pressed, and then TV responds with, for example, turning the TV on. Our idea is to read those codes and store them in our Wi-Fi remote so we can reproduce them or send them to a TV at any time without needing the original remote or having to press an actual button. In order to do that, we will first need to build an IR receiver, which is pretty simple. We will use ESP32 in combination with the IR receiver to read the codes and print them over serial. The IR receiver, you can probably salvage from an old piece of equipment or order one from your favorite e-store. In case you need links, I'll leave them in the video description. The one I have here is from an old LED strip, and I connected it as shown here. The VCC goes to 3.3 volts, ground to ground, and data out goes to our data pin 15 on the ESP32. After compiling the receiver sketch that is in the video description and uploading it to ESP32, we can open up the serial monitor and it should look something like this. Now, if we take our TV remote and point it to our IR receiver, when we press a button on the remote, serial port shows what code was received. In this case, this is our code shown in hexadecimal, and also what is the protocol. In my case, it says Samsung because this is a Samsung's TV remote. We can repeat this step for every button on the remote until we have all the codes. Okay, now that we have all the IR codes, we need to build an IR transmitter, or essentially our own TV remote. For that, we will add a transmitter IR LED to ESP32 so it can send codes to the TV. The IR LED I'm using is from an old remote, and in order to make sure it's getting enough current, we will drive it with an NPN transistor, or you could also use an N-channel MOSFET. Connect everything as shown here: LED anode to VCC, cathode to collector, emitter to the ground, and finally, base goes to D4 on the ESP32. And with that, hardware is complete, and one last piece of the puzzle remains, which is to create an interface to allow us to interact with the remote by using web browser. For that, we will design the page to look like an actual remote so it's more intuitive. The way it will work is, when we open this web page and click on a button, the ESP will detect which button was pressed and send a corresponding IR code to simulate as if the actual button was pressed on a real remote. I won't go into details how to design your own web page, but the source code is available for you to view and modify. Now, we have all the parts that we need. When we open our remote's IP address, we are greeted with a page that shows our virtual TV remote. When we click on a button, ESP knows exactly which button we pressed, and based on that, it will send an actual IR code. This is an equivalent of us pressing a button on a TV remote. And just like that, we have a remote that we can interact with from our phone, tablet, or PC, and best of all, we don't have to move it ever. Now we just need to package this up. I chose to 3D print an enclosure for my Wi-Fi remote since I have a 3D printer laying around, but you can create one using whichever technique and material you're most comfortable with. Finally, place it somewhere in the line of sight of your TV and then power it up. Open your favorite browser and navigate to ESP's IP address. You will be greeted with a web page that has a remote on it, and when you click on a button, we can see our TV is responding as if we were using the original remote that was provided with our TV. How awesome is that? One last note is that you can use this same project and follow the same steps to control any device that has an IR remote, or even consolidate multiple remotes into one single Wi-Fi remote. That was all for today's video. I want to thank you for making it to here. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit that like button and consider subscribing to my channel and sharing this video. It makes a huge difference and I really appreciate it. Okay, that's all for now. See you in the next video. Bye!